everyone, welcome back to Dragalia Lost. We are here for the next Gala Dragalia for the month of July, and it is one with a character that I would say is one of my favorites. Indeed, Odric from the latest main story chapter is here together with Summer Leonidas. So our goal today is to get, of course, Gala Odric. I had hoped that Summer Chell would be with him in this gacha, but it seems like that our friend Summer Leonidas is here instead, which is completely fine. I would love to go for bot, but understandably I don't have enough Wyrmites to guarantee the both of them if we get a laggy with either Gala Odric or with the Summer Chell gacha. And since there is some unforeseen stuff coming in the future, since the Gala Dragon pattern now will change, we have the anniversary very close, etc., I have to think twice before going ham on a gacha currently. But we'll see what we can do in the future. Those are thoughts that I have a lot of time to think over. We have plenty of new characters, however, thanks to the recent event and new stuff, the Summer Prince, which we covered the story yesterday, and I don't really think I want to do a showcase on him because he's very basic, similar to the standard prince, but not really an adventurer that warrants a showcase in my opinion, because he's plain, not really that difficult to use, and honestly, you can find better stuff in other adventurers in general, but not one too bad for coabs and stuff, he's somewhat decent to use. For us, however, the focus is on Gala Odric today. Just one little thing before we go there, I wanted to show you guys that I managed finally to do my first legendary clear. I did it on solo for the Fire Adventurers, and I got my Fire, not stuff, that's not the weapon that she has, but the Fire Lance for Mim, as you can see, as the special effect. So now we'll try to do the other legendary fights on my own and see if I can get other special effects on the weapons. Today we also got the last legendary, which is Tartarus, so I look forward to see if they are going to do the legendary versions also for the Dominion fights, which is probably what's going to happen. Okay, so we have 18,000 Wyrmites, 5 single pool tickets and 3 10 full tickets. Plenty to get a Gala character in my opinion, but we've been very unlucky with Gala characters in the past, so it could be that we don't manage to get him at all. That is the worst option in the table. Yesterday I had probably one of my best lucks in FGO in terms of gacha, so maybe my luck today will be bad, but I don't really think that luck works like that, so let's hope that that's not the case. Let's start with the 10 folds, since that is what we want to see in general for our summons. Okay, let's get hyped, my friends. We have to score 2 5 stars, or rather just 1, but if we get both of them I will be more than happy, because of course it is main characters, and I love to collect the main characters since those have the best stories usually, but as we've seen with the Summer Prince, it can be also that they have stories that are more on the fan side. Ok, this looks like an empty wall, which is completely fine. Let's build up slowly that 5 star gojo so that we can get into the midi part a lot more quicker. Come on, please give us Gala Odric, it is the character that I want, and I will do a showcase on him for sure. Not really sure when, because today will be full Dragalia, tomorrow we do the other adventurer story, but I have 2 videos that I want to do, one for Nier Reincarnation and one for Sao tomorrow, since we got a new event, so I'm kinda torn on whatever I want to do stuff. Looks like those first pulls aren't that laggy, but as I just told you, building up the gauche is as important, since if we get a better rate for the 5 star, it is more likely that we also get the both of them in one fell swoop. So let's hope that this is the ticket that brings us salvation, please. 5 star, come on. Ok, not yet. This is not a good sign, honestly, but we can see what we can do. Let's just skip ahead, because I don't think that there will be a spook. I would be wrong, because last time it went like this, that I thought nothing will happen, and then stuff happened, so I guess stuff could happen when we don't foresee it, but in that case it did not, so it is what it is. Again, okay, this is getting kinda weird. I never had 4 or rather 5 back-to-back 10 pulls without anything to show for it, even if it is a dragon, but could be a good sign, honestly, because it could mean that we be... Wait! Okay! 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 This is what I was talking about, that when we don't have a spook rate, and it doesn't show on the preview. This happens, that we get the character that we wanted like this. And I couldn't be more happy, because we managed to do it, my friends. It is Galahodrick. I love the little weapon that he has. Not little, but the character is so small, so they are kind of little weapons. It is sort of a mix between a polearm and an axe. It is pretty cool, in my opinion. And the model itself, I really like it as well, because of the wood. It is a very, very well-made character. Okay, let's do one last pull just to reach 50, so that I can feel happy that I tried for Summer Leonidas, and then we close this one all together. Who knows, maybe we get very lucky with Leonidas once again. Let's just skip, since it seems like it brought us more luck than we need to. Come on, Summer Leonidas, you can do it. Okay, nodding. Let's save up for Chell, shall we? We can waste some more Wyrmites on Chell, and then Summer Leonidas, I will cover his story with my other account on my other phone that I use for stories only. Which is kinda sad, because I would love to do a showcase on those characters, but that's the purpose of my second phone. Okay, so right now we have a Should You Pull To Do. I can safely say that I am happy with this result, because it is of course the Gala character, which is what we wanted. More than that, I don't really believe that we need to pull for characters that are permanent. If Summer Leonidas was limited, then I would have changed my mind, but I really want that Summer Chell. I really like Chell, probably a character that I miss on with the Gala. I got Gala Leonidas, I didn't get Gala Chell, so maybe if I get Summer Chell, it will be sort of a boon for the future. Okay, so let's go into the showcase info and start our Should You Pull. So first we have Galahodrick. It is a light axe, very interesting weapon type for him, because as you saw, his weapon isn't the typical axe that you see on every other adventurer. Does this mean that he has different attacks? Can't read that right now, but my guess will be that he has somewhat faster attacks based on his passive, which we'll see in a second. But even if he has the normal axe attacks, this character will be very powerful. Let's see why first. So we have the first skill, which is Over Karma. Consumes one level of the user skill reservoir. This is the Galahodrick mechanic. If you guys remember, she has a little bar on the top left with 3 levels of charging up. And each level consumes one of your skill gauges. And then you can link them together to do skill shift, which is basically the same mechanic that this character has. So is basically a light Galahodrick, but with a very different niche that we'll get into in just a second. Deals damage to enemies directly ahead, inflicts flash burn, which is the new affliction for light, not very used in currently, because not many characters have it, and dispels one buff from each target. So 3 very powerful effects: damage, flash burn, and dispel. Or rather, damage is not an effect, but you get the idea. After using this skill for a set period of time, it will be possible to trigger a skill chain. If Over Karma is activated during the skill chain window, a variant with different effects will be used instead. So let's check out the difference. First one is damage, dispel, flash burn. After skill chain, you get damage, dispel buff, and modifier if the enemy has flash burn. This will be the same also for the other skill, the second one. So the general idea, unlike Galahodrick, which was to inflict defense down and ailments, this time it is to give him more damage with flash burn modifiers, which means that Galahodrick is more of a bursty character compared to Galahodrick, not Summerahodrick. I was thinking that I would confuse the two, but here we are. Galahodrick is more oriented towards debuffs, in my opinion, with still a very good damage source, don't get me wrong. So the second skill, I just previewed it, but it is once again similar to the S1, consumes one level of the user skill reservoir and deals damage to enemies directly ahead. After using this skill, blah blah blah, you get a variant with different effects. So this is nothing too crazy, as you can see it is only raw damage, very low skill energy required, actually I believe that it is even lower, no, they are the same, so it is pretty easy to charge them up, but there is a skill reservoir, so it is kind of a given. So this deals more damage than the first skill, and it has also the modifier whenever you trigger the skill chain. So what is the rotation that you want to do with Galahodrick? First S1 to trigger the flash burn, of course, because you want it for the skill shift. then S2, and then I will do S1 again, because it is important also to dispel. Generally, on Lilith, I believe that it is useful, but it is more useful, especially when you are against Tartarus, to get off his stacks that have the purple moves activated, so it can be quite useful. Doesn't look like a very difficult kit to grasp, which can be quite good for new players. In my opinion, Galahodrick seems to be a very good character from this base skill set alone. Then we have co abilities, which are pretty good. We have a critical damage plus 30%. This, I believe, is the Halloween meme and Valentine Melody one, if I'm not wrong. I do believe that they have 22%, but it should be 30 for all three of them. I will go and check it out later on, but it is the same co-ability in general. So it is pretty good, because you have one for fire with Halloween meme and one for wind with Valentine Melody. Now you have one for light with Galahodrick. Of course, those were cross element, but now you also have the chain co-ability, which is pretty good because it is extra defense. Galahodrick also, being a pretty good character for Bust, etc., is a pretty good character for solo purposes, and you will see why in just a second. So we have his unique passive, which is Undying Will 2. You get a buff of attack rate by 2% every time he uses a skill, up to 10%. This is probably one of the best buff in the game, attack rate, so it is pretty good. Not really sure how long this lasts, because it doesn't say it, but it is very good to get it and keep it up, because as you can tell, more attack rate means that you charge up your skill reservoir more quickly. The other part describes the skill reservoir. As I told you, it is the same as Galahalex. You fill it with standard attacks for strike and dash attacks as usual. And then he has defense amp. So amp is the mechanic that we saw in the half year anniversary with Miriam, the first character that had an amp. And amp is all about having a buff that works in Dominion, but it is also a different type of buff, because it is level 1 and 2 are personal, and then on level 3 you get a separate buff that is for all the team. Defense amp doesn't look like one of the most useful of amps, because of course defense is good mostly for solo purposes, and if the enemy requires you to tank some crazy hits, which maybe the legendary Tartarus fight will do. But it is still kinda useful if you think about it, because for solo purposes it can be quite helpful, which is somewhat of a niche, but it is in my opinion still worth it somewhat. It is an extra, it is not something that defines Odric in my opinion. What defines him is the skill reservoir mechanic, same as Galahalex. However, I will say that he has the same effect as other Galas, where this is not really a defense amp battery for him, like he can keep level 1 at most. Summer Leonidas is more of the defense amp generator, but he is also in a different element, so until Light gets a defense amp generator, I don't believe that Odric can keep it up beyond level 1, which is completely fine in my opinion. Then he has double resistances as usual, which is pretty good for Tartarus. And then Gosh Accelerator plus 35%. This is actually pretty good, because he can spam skills, and with the attack rate he can burst through the overdrive Gosh. So it can be that he's kinda like speedster of the Gosh, like Gala Leonidas and Gala Shell, but with an axe, who knows. Now the question will be, should you pull for Galahodrick? In my opinion, absolutely yes, for three reasons. The first one is that he has one of the most successful Gala mechanics, because back when Galahalex released, she was one of the strongest Galas together with Galagleo, and in my opinion, it looks like he will keep that mechanic very well, because he has a low skill energy requirement, which means that the skill reservoir fills up very quickly. Damage is there, because the modifier seem pretty strong for him. He has a dispel, he has an affliction, and he has a pretty broken passive with the attack rate. Second will be the co-abilities. They are pretty good, especially for any light team. And in my opinion, the defense chain co-ability helps a lot for solo teams. And third will be that he is very good for solo purposes, because you get a ton of resistance, a ton of utility with the defense amp, and also the double resistance plus the overdrive, let's say, quick depletion that he has is pretty good. So yes, absolutely you should pull for Galahodrick. As usual, I will leave some extra info on the left for a recap if you want to go faster on why I feel like he is pretty good. Now we have Summer Leonidas. and is a very surprising adventure where I do think that he is also pretty good. He reminds me of a more offensive Delphi, while Delphi is more oriented towards a fully supportive role in inflicting poison against every enemy, plus also the other utility that he has as a support. Summer Leonidas is an attack unit that is fully dedicated on Shadow Blight. So we had plenty of Shadow Blight characters recently. We had Summer Yuden, Summer Mim, Galashel. There are plenty of them that can work very well with him. So he's actually very good as a sort of main DPS side support for Shadow Blight. Let's see why. We have the first skill, deals damage to enemies in a line and partially fills the user Dragon Drive Gosh. He has Dragon Drive, which is pretty good because it's not the burst type that we've seen with Nino and Mim. It is the normal type. During Dragon Drive, this deals damage to enemies in a line and lowers their Shadow Blight resistance. As you can see, two very things that are noteworthy: good damage on both in and out of Dragon Drive, and also very low skill energy requirement, which is pretty important because it means that you can fill up Dragon Drive pretty quickly. The Shadow Blight Rest Down is also very important because it means that you can tear down the defenses of Asura, for example, and you can inflict the Shadow Blight very reliably. This helps a lot with other characters that use Shadow Blight, like Summer Mim, Summer Yuden, etc., because it means that you can keep it up most of the time, but it is not the only effect that he has. We also have Phantasmic Servant. This deals damage to the target and nearby enemies and inflict Shadow Blight, so he can also inflict it to help his allies. Also grants the user a defense up and increases the entire team chances of inflicting Shadow Blight. So the chances increase plus the defense down from the enemy for Shadow Blight makes it possible to have a permanent Shadow Blight inflictor in Summer Leonidas, which is amazing for characters like Summer Mim, because Summer Mim had the problem where you spam Shadow Blight, but eventually the resistance of the enemy builds up to a point where it becomes very hard to keep it up. Thanks to Summer Leonidas, this kinda goes out of the window because he is very very good at inflicting Shadow Blight. He also has Defense Amp, which as I told you is a better battery to keep it up, because as you can see the skill energy is only 5000, and you should be able to keep it up very easily, especially if his skill generation is good when he's inside of our dear Dragon Drive, because he gets a special for strike which maybe gives him a better skill goal generation. Then he has Shadow Blight, which as we saw is pretty good for him because all his kit revolves around Shadow Blight in general. Co-abilities are generic: we have HP and then Shadow Blight equals Strength plus 13%, which for Summer Mim, Summer Yuden and of course Galashel could be pretty good. So all in all, not even a bad chain co-ability in my opinion. Then we have the unique passive, which is Summer Conqueror 2. It is the Dragon Drive passive, so he gets Dragon Drive, etc. And then he gets the following effects: the user for strike are changed and have 3 increase in 3 power for charge levels. Movement is possible, but at a slower movement speed. And the user strength is increased by 50%. My guess here is that he is a 4 strike focus character in Dragon Drive, and the 4 strike gets very good damage and very good skill generation, which means to me that his AI will probably be a very good defense amp generator, which for solo fight, especially for Asura, could be very very important, because it means that he will be able to make you tank most of the hits. Maybe for current Asura it is not as much of a problem because it is a very damage focused fight rather than defensive, but in the future it will be very cool, or rather very good for this role. Last but not least, we have Shadow Blight Edge plus 50%, which increases the chances of inflicting Shadow Blight by 50%. Another to add to the pile of his Shadow Blight effects, and as I told you, thanks to his Rest Down of Shadow Blight, all those effects will become very, very relevant. Should you burst for Summer Leonidas? In my opinion, yes, because as you learned in the past, units that revolve around an affliction are very very good for a variety of reasons: solo teams, support of other units that use the same affliction, and also in general enabling Punisher, which are one of the main sources of damage for many adventurers. So yes, you should pull for Summer Leonidas in my opinion if you want a better performance of Shadow Blight or in general Dominion teams in your Shadow teams, because he is a very good support slash DPS for bot. As I told you, it reminds me of Delphi, but in a more offensive style. Which, as we saw, how useful Delphi became when he got a mana spiral, because they kinda brought him up to speed. Summer Leonidas, not a Gala, is a very good character in the same fashion. And I would have loved to get him, because actually I have plenty of Shadowbite characters now, but it is what it is. Hopefully Shell will be somewhat similar, but for Light. I hope that she is a Flashburn type of support for Light, because I kinda need that for my Irene team. I love to use Irene, so it is what it is. Ok, my friends. This success, because it was a success after all, is very well earned. I will get the Gala Odric story out today, as usual. Not sure if after or before another video that I want to do, if I do that video, depends on the time that I have today. But for today, my friends, this is it. Thank you very much for joining me for another successful gacha for the Gala character, which this time was Gala Odric. Hopefully you will have your own luck with this gacha if you are going for both of them, or only Gala Odric or only Summer Leonidas, and for whenever we roll on Shell next week. Tomorrow we'll have the Summer Leonidas story, the day after we will have the This Day with Dragalia. As usual, if it is relevant I will cover it, if it is not I won't, but probably it won't because it is August. Probably the August and September one usually are kinda empty, so don't really expect much, but we will see. I will be back with the event story on Sunday, if that's the case. Once again, my friends, thank you very much for watching. Remember to like and sub to support the channel. Remember to check out the other Dragalia Lost videos and to leave a comment with whatever you got from the gacha. As usual, we'll be happy to see what you got. And also, if you like the new event, I think that it is kinda cool with all the siblings, etc. It was very enjoyable to read, in my opinion. This has been Hunter Lodge together with Gala Odric, which was one of my favorite characters and now is once again, because I will get to use him once again. Thank you very much for watching and hopefully I will see you next time. Have a good day and a good end of the week, and also everything else that might go good for you, hopefully it happens. This has been Hunter Lodge together with Gala Mim, and I'm out. Bye, my friends.